With what happened in Paris last night, Friday evening, it's very hard to post a video today. And it was hard to go to the movies last night. But I'm glad that I did because of the movie that I chose to see, The 33. And it was so uplifting and comes at such a perfect time, I think it's appropriate to review it today. Because if you're looking to get out of the house today to lift your spirits, no matter where in the world that you are, I think that The 33 is an excellent choice. There's a line in the movie which really rang true in light of the current circumstances, and it comes from a pastor in the film who's trapped in the mine. And one of the other miners who's battling alcoholism, is very difficult, doesn't get along with anyone else, he's consumed by hate. And he asks the pastor, he says, "Why don't you hate me like everyone else does?" You know, because everyone else has ostracized him for his behavior, but this pastor is reaching out to him. And the pastor says, "Because hate is for children." And, there's just so much hate in the world right now, and in so many different areas. For instance, yesterday I also saw the Danish girl, and, that touches on all the hate that we're seeing about how people choose to live their lives. And so to see that sentiment echoed so simply and eloquently in the movie, I really appreciated it, and it gave me strength. Also, the other thing about The 33 is that it portrays a group of people, ordinary guys, who find themselves against overwhelming odds in a tragic situation as the result of human cruelty, which of course also plays into current events. Now, in this situation, it's because of corporate greed. The private mining company that they work for obviously doesn't care about them. And it's not lost on the audience. The film does a very good job of pointing out the irony of the fact that these men are treated like dirt, yet they're mining for gold. So to see them be put in this situation by just the worst of humanity, to then come out of it with the best of humanity, to show that, again, is a great, great message at any time, but particularly now. I also liked the message of the movie, something else that they say with Antonio Banderas. A lot of great lines in this film. Antonio Banderas says, "I choose to believe." And he's not just talking about faith in God. I mean, there is a religious aspect to this film. But he's also talking about choosing to believe in himself. And I think that is my favorite message about faith, that it's not just believing in a higher power, but it's the combination of believing in a higher power, but also believing in yourself. And I think that's the most responsible message of faith that's out there. God is good for support, but God, if you actually want things to be done, it needs to be done by you and other people. And I think that's really fantastic. It's in sharp contrast to a trailer that's recently come out, obviously to play in front of this movie, Miracles from Heaven, Jennifer Garner. You might have seen this trailer. I reviewed it. Eugenio Derbez is also in the movie. And it's about a little girl who has a horrible illness that can't be cured, and she just happens to fall out of a tree, and the idea is that she falls on her head just the right way, and she cures herself. And so she just was sitting on a tree, and things just happened to her. It was an act of God. And I discussed that I felt that was somewhat irresponsible. I'll put a link to that trailer review at the end of this video. But here, in sharp contrast, that's not the message, that you need to do something too, that you have to step up to the plate, and the people in the mine and above the mine. And I think that's fantastic. And another reason I mentioned Miracles from Heaven is that the director, Patricia Riggen, is the same. And I think, Miracles from Heaven looks pretty by the numbers, but this film, one of the things I also liked about it was that it was very cinematic. For instance, Cesar Chavez, another recent movie that came out starring Michael Pena, and I've said this about a couple of movies lately. They just seem like HBO movies, right? There's no reason to go. Our Brand is Crisis, another film like that. You're like, why do you need to pay to see this in the theater? If the film didn't make an effort to make it cinematic, why should you pay the extra dollars? But The 33 is very cinematic, from the opening establishing shots of the beauty of Chile to inside the mine with the beams of light cutting through, and just to see that mine, by the way, and to see that people still earn their living this way. And this is still, for 100 years they make the point that this is where they've been mining, and this is still how things are done, is really, truly a sight to behold. So I think it was definitely worth seeing on the big screen. I also really liked seeing another part of the world, Chile, And it was, I think, depicted very authentically. And not all the actors were Latino. They had, like, Gabriel Byrne in there and Juliette Binoche. But everybody, and also a popular character actor often seen on 24 and the like is the Chilean president. And I was like, you're not Latino. But everybody worked very hard to still, you know, represent Chile. And I think it was great to see another part of the world rally to its own, to be its own savior, with America really not, I think, for the most part, coming to the rescue. So that was really nice to see come out of Hollywood as well. As for the cast, Antonio Banderas, it's like you really have a good group here. Antonio Banderas provides the energy. I mean, he just is really fantastic as Super Mario. But then Juliette Binoche does a great job of portraying the anger and, you know, a sense of justice. And then Rodrigo Santoro does a fantastic job portraying the heart of the film. So those three, that trinity, do just a fantastic job covering all the bases. So I really loved the 33. It came at a perfect time for me. Again, I felt really weird going to the movies last night. I felt weird, you know, I was struggling what video to post this morning. And this, not only was it the right movie for me to watch, but it feels like the right review for me to post right now. So of course, all of our hearts are with you. We're in Paris and what happened to you. And, you know, we choose to believe in you. And I think that that's the message of this movie, and that's really a great one. All right, so that's my review of The 33. I look forward to discussing it with you down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes right now.